Okay, last week we started out with using the arm bar and using, you know, the turnaround here and balance break. A lot of people have a tendency of doing arm bar like this. This is not the way we do arm bar. You know what I'm saying? Not at your levels. Not at your levels. Our arm bar should be actually effortless because it's a balance breaking arm bar. If you drop him down to the ground low, he's gonna be, you already got him. You see what I'm talking about? Everybody does this. Steps back, turns, and then they find themselves in this position trying to do arm bar. Arm bar is done with breaking his balance. If I don't even put my secondary hand in, I still can get him down in arm bar. Just by lowering his 1 point. Got me? You see how easy that was? And then you bring in the secondary hand, okay? So, what was important that in that class was this. This is the important part, is utilizing this right here to draw him, okay? It's the same as if I did this. You see it? Got it, guys? This and this is the same, okay? This and this is the same. You understand what I'm saying? So when we're gonna do a technique, we always use this type of stuff to set us up to do our techniques. So it's almost like a parry or a deflection. But I always call it sticky hands, you know what I'm saying? I always kind of relate it to like a sticky hand because I wanna even if he pushed at me, I could actually do my technique without him having any effort. Almost like that Chinese art Wing Chun where they actually utilize the twisting of the wrist. I'm gonna show you. From here, there's several techniques that we can do. Armbar is one. Last week we did armbar. We broke armbar down for about a good hour and a half, didn't we? Oscar, you was here, Jay? No, Louis was here.
I was here.
You was here, right? We broke it down for almost an hour. Made it easy for you guys to do class. I mean, to actually teach it to some of the lower belts, you know? What we do in here is a lot more advanced than what they do in the other classes. So remember that when you're trying to show somebody that you're gonna get corrected sometimes, okay? Because a lot of what we do is more advanced, okay? But stuff like little tips, like using the arm bar and breaking balance is one thing that any sensei could actually correct you. Because that's actually the way you're supposed to do it. Okay? All right. Remember this? This is the same thing. So if he threw a punch and I wanted to do what? Armbar, I can do it, right? If I wanted to do armbar throw, I can do it, right? If I wanted to parry, I can do it, right? Watch. Seeing it? Again, armbar. Parry. All right, so what I'm gonna get and what I'm getting into now is using now that same arm bar effect, but this time we're gonna pass it. So we're gonna utilize this. Now if you're gonna try to put his hands on my chest, boom, that's what he's gonna try to do. Boom, you see it? Again, boom. What do we have? Drop. Same thing. But it comes from this. What do we have? Handshake. Alright, so what I want you guys to start doing now is finding technique. What do we have? Arm bar throw.
You want the block to go this way so you can then turn your hand.
I want it to go down because we're doing cross. We're doing cross. Mirrored image, guys. Then I'm gonna show you how to do the techniques from here. So it's gonna be, is he gonna push in my chest? Boom. Deflection. Try to push your chest. Boom. flexion. Sit.
You want the palm, that's what I'm saying, you want the palm up, or you want it like this?
Just like this.
Okay.
See, because right now, if I go under, I parry you without grabbing.
Okay.
See it? Watch again. See it?
Yes.
See it? All right, go ahead and work on that. I want you guys to find techniques from that. You guys are high belts, you should be able to find stuff. And then I'm gonna walk around. Highs work for lows. Remember, guys, I know you guys want to jump to the applications, but what I really want you guys to do is feel this energy coming at me. Feel the energy, you know? I mean, the push can come harder and harder if it wants, you know? You see? I want you guys to feel this energy that's coming. Go ahead, go. Feel the energy. What I need Nage to do is to move. Now move. You see how he's running?
Uh-huh.
Now move. And then utilize the move. Actually, I got a hook. Utilize that to do your technique. You see where you're going? And you see where I'm turning that?
Mm-hmm.
So if you could do your handshake like that, I'd be very happy.
Alright?
Don't have to throw him either. If I get him whipping around like that, whoa, he's running into his own technique. You understand? Go ahead, feel that, guys. Remember, that starts it. But you gotta move. You gotta touch the bottom. Go.
Slow.
I want him to run around you. I don't want you to run around nobody. One. Seen it?
Yep.
Slow. I'm already turned. I'm already stationed. I'm letting him follow his own wrist. You feel that?
Oh, yeah.
If you put it into a circle, he's already there. Now I can just do my technique. Whoops. That's what I'm looking for. I'm not looking for this. You have to turn already. Turn. I think I turned even before. Bang, he's mine. And I set him up. Go ahead, guys. Try it.
Tommy.
You're not there. He should throw that way. See where he is?
Yeah.
His throw should be that way. One. There he goes.
Right.
And then put it around you and lean it forward.
Yeah.
Almost like you're doing a bring in front. Touch that wrist.
Whip.
It's almost like that. I'm taking this thing and I'm throwing it that way. That's what we're doing with the whip. What? Okay, go. Lead him out. I want to lead him out. Lead him out. Don't go back. You're going back and stopping the momentum. You created it. Don't lose it. Don't lose it. Let him keep going. There you go. But you got to let him catch up. No, sit up. Listen up. You got to let your move can't catch up. Listen up. You have to let your uke catch up, because if you don't, you got him twisted. He's running around you, trying to stay up with you. So, if the push is coming and you turn, now I lead, see it? I let him catch up to me. But this right here, this little jerk right here, whack, catches him, go right into his own technique. Got me, you feel that? Boom, jerk him. This one right here is from the arm bar, right? You see it? See the arm bar? Jerk him. Ah, he goes right into his technique. Go ahead, guys. Go.
Back and forth.
Teach you how to hook at the very last minute to bring him in. That's why he comes so fast to me, is because I bring him in. As he's coming, See it?
Uh-huh.
It's right here, guys. It's right here. Right at the stump area where the wrist, this is where you hook him. So if he's going one way, I want to bring him the other way. This is the way I want to do it. I want to bring him in. So it starts off with shaking. Remember, always shaking, okay? It's always this. As he pushes, man, got him right here. Ooh. You see that? Watch it again. Oh, man. I got him. Close. See it? Watch it again. It comes. Whoop. That's what I want. Again. Go ahead, guys. Go. I watch.
This hurts you.
Questions on the handshake. Do I have to teach you how to do the handshake? I don't think so, because a handshake is almost the first technique you learn when you're a white or a yellow belt. And it's supposed to be a third set. But everybody does it because it's natural to do it. But if you use the energy of a person coming in and use that energy going out, you're going to see how easy it is to do. But your whole thing is slingshotting. Like, think of the slingshot. And then that'll help you actually understand the technique a lot better. Got me? If you can think about slingshot, then think about that. Because the slingshot is the whip. The whip is a slingshot. And it's not, there's no pain involved, but it's energy that causes the technique to work. And then with that energy, you do the lift up at the very last second, causing the body to flip. You understand what I'm saying? So what's happening is that when this thing is going out in like a whip, and then the wall hits it, the body has a tendency of going up because it's almost like you're going against the wall. This is what happens. Because you want to go back to its natural form, which is that. Got me? So that's what the whip makes you do. Now, we'll take the whip and think about the whip as the same technique. Boom. Feel that, puppy? Again. The same exact move with the hand is this move. But what we're going to do is we're going to lead it and take it straight down. Whoops. Now, if he doesn't know how to fall, how is he going to fall face first? He's going to eat the blacktop. Because you see what I'm doing? I'm taking him down. I'm not doing this, guys. That I'm not doing. The reason why I go down is because I accelerate the speed. Got me? I accelerate the speed. And remember when we were talking about taking balance breaking? Balance breaking is when you're doing the arm bar and you drop them straight down and point, boom, it falls on his face. I'm doing the same thing with the drop.
That's what's spinning on. When you spin them and stay straight down?
Same thing. So if he's coming, push at him.
Push.
Oh, he has to roll.
Yeah.
And let me tell you something. I did this technique to a guy from a Tam Sun old school. Actually, he's passed away. His name is Vincent. And he broke his shoulder on this technique because he couldn't go. And I shouldn't have done it. But I thought he would roll. And it's a technique that you don't think you're going to get hurt out of, and boom, the guy broke his shoulder in class, okay? And I didn't see him for another 6 months, so shame on me, but you know, live and learn. Go.
Did he die because of the broken shoulder?
No. Broken heart, actually. Broken heart. Okay. Remember this, guys. This is very important. This is very important. And then the transition. Watch how the transition applies. Let me do that. You understand? So I'm gonna step back and drop it down. You see what I just did?
Mm-hmm.
Again, he's coming in, push, drop him down. Go ahead, try it, guys. You're down on your knee, and if you don't use your knee, if you can stay up, I'm fine with that too, but he has to go down. And you got it. Defense line. I want everybody to get to throw. You're up. Sensei, you're next.
Seniority, please.
Right here, guys, don't come at him like that. I don't want this, guys. Push him, push him. Guys, push. Push. Yeah, there you go. Push him. Nice, good. Yes. Nice, good. No, I don't want him to roll. Okay, just go to the back. This is a hard form. See that? Don't do that. Let it come. Let it go out. Let the energy leave. Let the energy leave with him.
Linear like that.
Linear, right. Let him take the energy. Go. Push him. There you go. Push him. Stop. Alright, remember, use this right here. Use this here. Utilize this hand right here. This hand is gonna put it right where it needs to go. Go. Very nice.
Sir, I'll come at you left hand.
Very nice, Joe. Joe top. Oh no. Good guys.
I'm still being
nice. Oh, yeah. Do it again.
I'm still being nice.
Yeah. I don't want that. You don't freaking push him. He's a big boy. Push him, push him. Gosh. There you go, go.
He caught me off guard the first time.
Push him.
He's dead low.
That's a push. You see what he did? He didn't come from like 20 feet away, like this. He came up running and then he pushed. And that's realistic. Go ahead, go. Nice. Huh? Top, go.
Yes. Yes, sir. Yes.
Now that you gotta translate that hand. And guys, believe me. The speed is coming fast. You have to get used to that. You gotta, timing is a must in this technique. So is the handshake. If timing is not there, you mess up everything. Remember that you're the center. You have to create the center with this technique and take charge of it. You know what I mean? Because if your center is overtaken by the attacker, your technique's gonna be shit. You know what I mean? Okay.
Just keep right hand straight.
Right. That's what doesn't pull back. So why is application being pulled back?
We're helping people roll, is what I believe.
I don't want you to help.
Right, no.
If you can't roll in this class, you need to go to some other class. Got it? Helping roll is, you want to do rolling classes? I mean, the rolling classes. Go ahead.
So would you say to let it go?
Let it go.
Leave it down and let it go. That's what it does.
You came down.
Don't hold on.
Let it go.
Let it go.
Let it go.
Out on the street, we hold on. Out on the street, that's what you want. I love you guys. I don't want you guys to get hurt. You know, as tough sometimes as I am, by letting it go, it's actually letting you roll. It's teaching you how to roll and run. And at the same time, it's teaching you that the whip is very powerful. And people don't think the whip is powerful. It is powerful. Mm-hmm. It's a powerful technique. Watch. Because that can make them. That can make them not roll.
I felt that here.
Yeah. I can make them not roll.
It contorted like the.
You see over the shoulder. What was the difference between what I did the first time and what I just did right there?
You went straight down.
And pulled them straight down.
Yeah.
And I let him go. But if I really wanted to, he would have hit his head. Because I am guiding him. He is following this. Look at his whole reaction. Okay?
Yeah, I'm good.
And then I'm doing this.
Oh.
Okay? That is action.
I felt this accordion.
Yeah.
When we do this action?
Yeah, I'm whipping that right out.
I felt this.
Okay. Yeah, that's why it's called whip.
Yeah. Whip action.
Doing that. But then you do this. And if I take you straight down, head first.
Ooh, thanks, player.
All right, so what you want to do is just lead them out, don't bring it back. Let them roll out. Go ahead, go.
Ready, sir?
Hey! Nice, good. Go. Left hand.
Nice.
Good. Very nice, good. Very nice, good. One more, with them, right?
Yes.
All right, everybody understands that?